Hello, my friend, and welcome back. Today, I would like to talk about something that I feel is kind of coupled with maybe the last video or the last couple videos that I have made, talking about this fresh new start and that we are kind of like maybe in a new phase or a new stage of whatever is happening, and that we need to take it as a fresh start and that we need to be kind of evaluating our lives and, you know, seeing where we need to change things up. So today I would like to talk about something that really resonated with me that I heard, and I know that it can't just apply to me. So in this time of reevaluating and starting new and this fresh start, we also need to make room for the divine. And to make room for the divine to help us to co-create in this new stage of life what we actually would like to create and what we are here to do. And in order to do that, we need to be consciously working on releasing resistance. And the kind of resistance that I am talking about right now is kind of that forceful resistance. When we feel like our human minds feel like something should be a certain way, or something should have happened by now, or I've been being told to be patient and patient and patient. When, what am I being patient for? When is this gonna happen? When am I, you know, I've been seeing signs that there are big changes coming. What are these changes? How do I deal with them? And if, you know, we're waiting for these big changes, you know, what do I need to be doing in the meantime? When we start getting wrapped up in that and all those questions and the what ifs and the whens and the hows, that is all resistance. It is all, like, I can even just even saying that, I can feel my energy heightened. And when it is in that state, you are not in a state of receiving. You are in a state of lack. And I don't even mean receiving physical things. I mean even receiving information, direction, reassurance from the divine. And I was listening to an intuitive last night, and she gave an amazing example. She said that you need to get on the lazy river right now and let the epiphanies flow to you. Now, this resonated with me when she said it, but this morning when I was out back, I play with Lorenzo every morning in the backyard. And as I was walking around playing with the dog, I was reflecting on that, and I was thinking about exactly what she was saying, you know, to be on that lazy river, and I need to just let the epiphanies come. And at that exact moment, I looked down, I just happened to look down, and there was a feather on the ground. And to me, that was the sign of reassurance of yes, the divine saying yes, yes, yes. And, you know, you may say like, oh, well, you're outside, feathers are very common. But when it syncs up, when there's that kind of synchronicity and it resonates with you, it is a sign. You know, I don't know if it's a saying, but like, you know, it has been said that the only reason that something is not a sign is because you didn't take it as a sign. So if you are taking something as a sign, then it is a sign. And, you know, going back to like, what if it was just like a coincidence? Well, there's a very small area of our yard that I play. It's like kind of like a dog run. And I had been out there for like 5 minutes walking in that same area and had not noticed the feather. So for it to be that kind of timing, it was definitely a sign. And it was really reassuring, and it was very nice to see. Because, you know, we complicate things. The ego complicates things. Life is meant to be much more simpler than we make it out to be. And, you know, I have a lot going on in my life right now. I say I'm in a big stage of transition, and like a lot of that transition is happening internally, and it's not exactly external, but my ego, my thinking mind, gets so fixated on the external. This hasn't changed. You still are doing this that you don't love. This isn't happening yet. Why is this not happening? You have a ton of stuff to do, but you don't have anything to do. And, you know, it just gets very fixated. And it was really just nice and reassuring. And it's kind of like a sigh of relief to know that it is a little bit easier than I'm making it out to be. I just need to be on that lazy river and in the flow of life. And I need to be able to, my job is to get me to a point that I can receive those epiphanies. And that they will come in perfect timing. And even though I feel like I have been being patient and listening and doing everything I'm supposed to, but nothing is freaking happening, I need to understand that that is my ego that feels like I have been patient enough and I have waited long enough. Everything is in divine timing, and the divine is perfect. Therefore, the divine timing is always perfect. It is just our egos that feels like it should have happened that way. And I try and keep myself in check to where I put it in perspective, like, what if what you were waiting for and the changes that are going to happen, what if they happen, and then in hindsight, you would have wanted even more time? What if you would have wanted them to hold off even more? Because what if it's a change like Corona, you know? You know, when Corona first happened, I didn't feel like that. Like, I didn't have that kind of reflection. But I also wasn't exactly, I felt like a big change was coming, but obviously had no idea. And obviously just was in it and went with it and flowed with it and, you know, just tried to make the best of it. I've also been trying to imagine Corona, like, you know, the saying of a wolf in sheep's clothing. Well, I've been trying to imagine it as the opposite, as a sheep in wolf's clothing. Like, it is a blessing in disguise. You know, we have to look for the gifts right now. And looking for those gifts, and I'm taking the sign of, you know, being on the lazy river, being told to be on the lazy river, and letting the epiphanies come to me, that is a gift. Those words were more of a gift to me than I think that I even realized, or that person even realized when they said in their video. They obviously didn't know I was going to watch it and take it that way, but I am really, really grateful for that. Because when we can get into the flow and we can be on that lazy river, a lot of that suffrage goes away. That suffrage was created by me saying, why hasn't this happened yet? This should have happened. What the frig am I waiting for? What is happening? I need to go harder. I need to reevaluate. Where can I do better? More, more, more. That feeling is really suffrage. That is where the suffering is in. I'm not in that much pain right now, but I am suffering a lot by way of my own ego. And the divine doesn't want that for us. The divine wants us to understand our place, to understand that the divine wants us to live a life full of ease and grace. It does not want us to suffer. God wants us to be in peace, love, and joy and wholeness all the time. And the reason why the divine wants that is because that is the truth. There is nothing else. There is no separation. There actually is no suffrage. It is just a complete fabrication of our ego. And that is something that I really want to take into heart during these times, right now, currently, and moving forward. I still feel we're in a fresh start, and I still want to reevaluate things, but I want to reevaluate things from my inner tube on the lazy river. I don't want to reevaluate things in a critical way of where can I be doing more? Where can I push harder? Where is it more? I want to reevaluate things from my inner tube on the lazy river, saying, you know, taking an objective look at each area of my life, where I would maybe want to see it improve a little bit, and what is the easiest way? What is the most effortless way? What is the most aligned way for me to move forward in that area of my life? And then also just receiving epiphanies, receiving gifts, receiving miracles all day, every day. That is the state that I want to come from. Not exactly the worried state of that I'm not doing enough and that things should be different. Maybe I missed a sign. Maybe I'm not following my intuition. Maybe I'm not hearing my intuition enough. That is the state that I have been coming from. And I am so grateful that I got that gift of those words from someone last night. And I hope that this video resonated with you. I hope that these words come to you at a time that you most needed to hear them. And I want to thank you. I want to thank you so, so much for tuning in. My name is Anne, and I hope to see you next time.